Good day, everybody. Connor McIver, REMAX Santa Clarita, headquartered, of course, in Santa Clarita Valley. This is your Saugus Real Estate Update. Today is going to be the 23rd of July, Thursday. It's 9:19 a.m. as I'm recording the show. Now, this last week, we actually did a Saugus update last week to kind of give you a little bit to compare it to. And in fact, we do see that the coming soon listing field is being used more and more by agents. Just to let you know, this is the longest running real estate radio show and podcast for Santa Clarita Valley, specifically Santa Clarita Valley cities. I'm Connor McIver. I've been selling real estate since 1998, representing both buyers and sellers since that time. And I'm with REMAX Gateway, REMAX of Santa Clarita, REMAX of Valencia, all the same company, just different DBAs. So there you go. So when you're looking online, you find Connor McIver. Well, then you found me. So let's get into this real estate trend that we're currently seeing right now in Saugus, as in the other Santa Clarita Valley cities. We are seeing a seller's market. That's where the market is currently. That means that the sellers have some advantage over the buyers out there. The reason why it's a seller's market primarily is the lack of inventory for sale. Now in Saugus, of course, if you've driven up Plum Canyon, you've seen the hillside up there to the northeast kind of side of Plum Canyon, where Plum Canyon wraps into White's Canyon. You see all that hillside being developed up there behind the fire station, and also that new mini mall that they put up there, the little strip mall with the Starbucks, and there's going to be a grocery store. There's also a piece of land plotted up there for an elementary school. When that's going to happen, I don't know. But up there, you do have a lot of new construction. You have several different builders up there that are on premises, and you do have some new housing that happens to be for sale. Now, I will tell you that going up there and looking, you're going to be facing mellow roofs for the most part. Some of the builders are sold out. Other ones have more phases to be able to add to their inventory. But again, it's not a huge amount of real estate inventory that's going to be built up there, at least in the foreseeable future. There are going to be several more phases released by one of the bigger builders up there. And with all of that, that's going to increase the numbers of properties for sale in Saugus. But again, they're not going to really be building standing residential real estate. They're going to have it where you go out there with me, hopefully, because I'll be there to represent you at no cost to you, and with all the other benefits of my powers of negotiation. Well, there's actually a lot there. But when we go out to the property together, what you'll see is the way that I speak with the new home rep, trying to get discounts, incentives, and also looking for those properties that were already agreed to be purchased, yet are falling out of escrow. When that happens, the builder sometimes acts to retain the original agreed upon price, thereby you buying that property at a substantial discount over other properties that are going to be coming, or other phases that are going to be released. Good to know. But again, that new housing inventory isn't going to bite into the resale inventory that much, and we are still in a seller's market with not very much inventory on the market for sale. When there's a house in Saugus, California that's priced correctly, and it is somewhere between $400,000 and $650,000, typically that house in Saugus goes out with multiple offers, multiple bids, multiple buyers. The seller is going to respond to each one of those offers depending on their agent and what their agent's saying for them to do. But for the most part, it's most beneficial for a seller to try to respond to everybody that did write an offer on that piece of real estate, because you never know how people might change. They might increase the price. They might change their financing. They might come in a windfall, maybe through the family, maybe somebody's, you know, some aunt stepped forward and said, "Oh, honey, I love you. I'll lend you $300,000. I'll give you $300,000 or whatever it is. So all that stuff can change, but without giving them a chance, you'll never really know what they were capable of doing. Maybe sometimes sellers just want to select one of the offers to save themselves a headache. Maybe the agent is convincing them just to select an offer to save themselves, the agent's a headache. But at the end of the day, countering everybody really is profitable in more ways than one. So that's something to consider. All right, so we're going to talk about Saugus inventory currently. In the coming soon realm, and as compared to last week in Saugus, California, there were two properties that were of the coming soon variety. Now, as of today, there's seven coming soon. Coming soon, and I wrote a blog post on this. In fact, I'll try to link this into the articles. But if you punch in Santa Clarita Home Experts, coming soon, do a Google search, you'll see the article. With regard to coming soon listings, this is something new that's been added as of the beginning of May of 2020. So it's very fresh. It's a listing category like active is, like active under contract, like the backup offers used to be, like pending properties are, sold properties are. This is just another category, but it allows agents to take a real estate listing that they have a contract on and enter it into the multiple listing service as coming soon. That's also known as a pocket listing, used to be back in the day. So the agents can use this category to take this listing and put it onto the market prior to it being viewed by most people. But in this regard, you will see it, but you're not going to see it on Zillow or Realtor.com or Redfin or even on our website, SantaCruzHomeExperts.com, because the coming soon field, at least as of now, the 23rd day of July 2020, Thursday, the coming soon field is reserved for MLS members only, multiple listing service member only, i.e. me. And what we would do is, if I do have you on a search, I know your criteria, I know what you're looking for, I know what cities you're looking for, what neighborhoods potentially you like, or I offer up, because of my knowledge and experience, what areas are going to fit your needs by what you've told me, then potentially I can set up, or I will set up a search, not potentially, but really, I'll set up a search, and it's going to include those coming soon listings. So if you're looking for a 3-bedroom, 2.5-bath on the west side of Seco Canyon, for example, in Valencia there, when one does come on the market, and if the agent is using the coming soon field, you're going to see that first. You're going to see that listing immediately. So then what happens next is, now you prepare to view the listing with us as your agents. So we'll get that showing set up. In some cases, the listing may be able to be seen prior to it going active, but at least this way, you're going to be first in when it does go active, when that happens to happen. So that's the coming soon listing field, and currently there are 7 Saugus properties in that field. So let's give you the street names. You have one on Robin in the Bokeh Villages. That's 834 square feet. That one's priced at 314. You have one on Haskell Canyon Road, number G, at 320. That's also a 2+2 as well. The other one on Robin's a 2+1, 939 square feet. You have one coming on Doss Place at 339. You have one calling on Marbury Court at 599. Edmonds, 649. Griffith, 925. Windriver Court, 979. That's a big house of 4,500 square feet. So you can see we've ran the gamut. We have 3 condos, 4 single family residences, all in the coming soon category for Saugus Real Estate. All in all, active 58 total listings in Saugus, California, active and for sale, currently on the market. Santa Clarita Home Experts is a good source for that. It's a local site, it's my site. I don't ask you to register. I just ask at some point when you're ready, save your search so you're seeing these listings. Once you save it, then I'll reach out to you personally and I'll say, hey, what exactly are you looking for? And then I'll be able to build you that coming soon search so you'll see listings that fit your criteria even before they enter the market for sale, because I am a member of the multiple listing service in good standing, full-fledged, the whole 9 yards. So that's going to be those properties active at 56. Verify 58, I'm sorry. Active under contract, we have 57. Those are properties that are in escrow. We also have 92 properties that are pending status in Saugus, California, also in escrow. So that's quite a bit. We do, so that's about 150 listings currently that are in the escrow process. In comparison to the mere 58 we have that are active, once we run out of that inventory, if no new houses or no resale houses were put on the market for sale, we would actually be out of inventory within a month and a half in Saugus, California. That is running on par with the rest of the Santa Clarita Valley cities, indicating again that we're still in a seller's market. If home buyers for Saugus, California weren't active, weren't out there looking for residential real estate, and if the days on market timeframes were long, meaning it's taking long to sell properties, not within hours or a few days, but a long time, months, multiple months, so on, then it wouldn't be the seller's market that we see. But buyers are very active, and the reason why buyers are completely active, very active in Saugus, happens to be because we do have incredibly low interest rates all across the board, for residential loan mortgages. It's a big refinance market as well in Saugus. There are a lot of you property owners that are looking to refinance again to get under the 3.0% rate. It does seem like that is happening for a lot of people. Just a couple suggestions on that front before I continue with our Saugus real estate housing broadcast for this week. I would tell you, look for a couple different sources. Go to the bank that currently has your mortgage, see what they can do. Have what they can do, what they tell you they can do with regard to changing your interest rate and fees. Have them put that in writing. And then also go to a local source. We like Augusta Financial out here, Mike Mina. Give them a call and they will take great care of you and see if they can beat what your bank is telling you they will do. And find out who's going to be your best deal on fees and also interest rate. Give a local a chance to see what they're able to do to you. Eventually, that loan, they might loan on it themselves or they might sell it off. But at the end of the day, they have a couple hundred different sources for money. Being with Augusta Financial and that brokerage, they have a couple hundred different sources of money that are going to compete for your business, well, for their business, and ultimately for your business. So they might actually be able to give you a better deal than your current mortgage holder. Good to know. All right, so then we're going to punch in the last 7 days of sold properties. So we're going to do that real quick. We have in the last 7 days in Saugus, California, 19 listings have actually closed, sold escrow. In the last 7 days, we have zero properties that expired, not selling within contractual timeframes, which is good for those sellers out there. A lot of times, none have been canceled as well in the last 7 days. That's also good information. Here's a category that I always bring up every time I do a real estate radio show, which is, well, every day. This one happens to be for Saugus this day. Tomorrow, by the way, is going to be our Newhall real estate update. So make sure if you're interested in Newhall real estate, you're an owner there, make sure you tune in for that. But as far as what I like to talk about gets into the hold category. These are properties that are being held from rendering as active on the market for sale. What could be happening? Well, there could maybe be a disagreement that's arisen between the agents on those properties. It could be that potentially there is a lot of activity and the agent is overwhelmed with offers. It could be, and whether that's legit or copacetic with the Board of Realtors or not, that's a whole other question because there are rules to use this category. An agent just can't go out and use it just for the fun of it. Excuse me, I'm parched. Black coffee, nothing like it. Reminds me of Dad, dear old Dad. All right, so moving on to the other option out there. If somebody has a house that they're wanting to sell, but maybe a family member got sick, maybe it's a COVID-related issue, lots of different reasons, they could actually tell the agent, you know what, I don't want any showings for a while, and the agent would potentially put that property on hold. There are 13 of these properties. If you're looking in a very restricted inventory area like Saugus, California, or any one of the other Santa Clarita Valley cities, you owe it to yourself not only to have your agent or us, if you don't have an agent, set you up with the coming soon listings. You owe it to yourself to make sure your realtor is also searching the hold listings and the do not show listings. It could be that this just happened. The property, in fact, maybe even before it happened, maybe the agent isn't familiar with coming soon, isn't used to that category, so they're not using it. At the moment they were about to make the property active, they get a phone call from the seller, and the seller tells them, hey, listen, Jack, we're going to have to hold off on the summing and on the showings of the property because my mother-in-law, who lives in the downstairs bedroom, actually came down with a sore throat and a fever, and we're concerned that it could be a COVID-19 coronavirus type deal. So what is that, 14 days? So they give it some time and see what happens, and maybe take mother-in-law to the doctor and have her checked out to see if, in fact, it is COVID or the coronavirus. If it happens to be, that coffee just makes you, if it happens to be that, then that property is probably going to be on hold for a while until it all gets cleared out because there are documents that the seller has to sign talking about any potential exposure to the coronavirus to make sure people viewing the house are kept safe. So there is a fail-safe mechanism in there. Let's look at withdrawn real quick. These are properties that actually were pulled off the market. And that's going to reflect as 9 total. One property within the last 7 days was actually canceled and removed from the market or withdrawn from the market as being active and for sale. This is another category that isn't bad to look at to kind of give an idea. There's a property on Plum Canyon, one on Tula, Luzon, Arden Place, Magnolia Way. These ringing a bell with anybody? Layton, Astor Way, Linda Lane, Ellery Place. These have all been withdrawn. It could potentially be that if these aren't under contract, these are also options for you as real estate buyers, because your agent, very simply, could do their due diligence and give the listing agents a call and say, what's going on with Ellery Place? I have a client that's really interested. I just met them, or I would have shown it to them before while it was active. What's going on with it? The agent might inform me that, hey, you know, I lost the listing. They don't want to sell it right now. And then I would definitely go bang on that door without trying to be too obtuse, and at least ask them, hey, I do have a buyer, real buyer. This is their pre-approval letter. This is their love letter. These are real people. It's not me trying just to solicit a listing that's been withdrawn from the market, which does happen a lot. Is that a good place for air quotes? Probably. So it does happen a lot. Watch out for that. I am Connor McIver. That's your Saugus Real Estate Update. I'm here for you when you're ready. I do have a lot of information to give, and I am a good listener. Be safe. Connor McIver, thank you so much for watching, and we will talk very soon. Reach out to me when you're ready. If you want to see the current inventory without having to give up who you are and all that other fancy stuff, go to SantaClaritaHomeExperts.com/Saugus. SantaClaritaHomeExperts.com/Saugus. And you'll see all the active inventory here in Saugus, California. I'm Connor McIver. Check out our Santa Clarita blog. Just Google that. You'll see the Santa Clarita Home Experts website blog. And feel free to enjoy all of the articles and updates that I put together. Tomorrow's Newhall, folks. We're going to talk about Newhall, California, which was the original city out here in the Santa Clarita Valley way back in the day, named after a surveyor. I think that's the correct history. That was surveying this land for the state of California. Be safe. Connor McIver, over now.